Hey, hobo. What's up, dude? What's up, dude? Photographic evidence of Devin petting a dog.
I've petted plenty of dogs in my day. Grizzly trying to get the boulder.
Here we go, King. Good boy, Popcorn.
I'm sorry, dogs. I'm so fat.
Oh, you're doing a great job, guys.
You don't have to pee on everything, though. That was like the mark of the territory here. Good dogs. Here you go, Fudgy. That's a good time to do it, I suppose. Hold your breath.
Crop dusting.
Yeah, smell it.
Eddie, hey! Good dogs.
Top of the hill. All down the hill.
Snap up snow the whole way. Good dogs.
All right, ready? Hey. Here we go. Good boy, Larry. Is just kind of slacked up, and that's pretty characteristic of Larry. He's having a good time though, just prancing along, enjoying. And then in the third row on the left side, the big fluffy white guy, that's Charlie. Charlie is 7 years old. He's probably the most mellow dog you'll ever meet. He doesn't really get excited about anything, but he enjoys life. When I was getting all the dogs excited, ready to go, I came up to Charlie and he was just laying on the ground and he yawned at me. He stood up and he was like, okay, I guess it's time to run. And then on his right is Snow White. Snow White's one of the shy dogs. She was rescued from a hoarding situation. So the first couple years of her life, she wasn't really super, she didn't have any human interaction. So even now, she's not super stoked to meet people. But she loves to run, and that's kind of one of the only times that she'll come out and let us approach her. So Snow White's there. And then in the fourth row, on the left side, the white dog with the booties on, that's Popcorn. Popcorn came to us from Illinois, so did Lazy Larry. They had a musher out in Illinois, and he passed away a couple years ago, so his wife was calling around and trying to figure out what the hell to do with 20 sled dogs, and eventually she got in contact with us, and we drove out to Illinois, picked up 20 dogs and a cat, and brought them back. The cat doesn't live here, but the dogs do, and Popcorn, he's a great dog, he's super cool, he's got a great personality, he works really hard. And then on Popcorn's right, the big fluffy brown guy, that's Mars. Mars is 10 years old. This is his last winter before he retires and goes up for adoption. Mars is kind of a big deal because his dad was, his grandparents were both from Alaska. He was one of the second litter to be born at our kennel. He's a Mackenzie River Husky. And he's super strong. He works really, really hard. He's getting old. And he'll be a great dog. A great house dog for sure. He's a little bit shy with new people, but he's a good looking boy. And then back here in the back on the left side is King. King is actually Charlie's brother. King's pretty shy with new people. It took him about a month for him to warm up to me. But now he likes me, and he kind of figures new people out real slowly. But King's a hardworking guy. And then on his right is Copper. Copper's another one of those professional dogs that's taking the winter off from racing. Copper's a big deal because his breeder is actually a guy named Lance Mackey, who's an Iditarod champion. So the guy who bred him races these 1,000-mile-long races in Alaska, and actually has won it 5 years in a row from 2007 to 2012.
Wow.
So Copper comes from a great place. He's a real hard-working dog. He looks like a weird wolf that's been compacted a little bit, but he's a good guy. the little snow machine.
Have you guys done the snow machines?
Yeah, I used to have, well, I have two of them, but one, like, rotted to death, because...
Yeah.
And then one, the seat fell off, I was riding it. They were old.
Yeah. Yeah, as long as you can have a good time on them, no matter what they look like.
My parents have 10 acres of land in Rhode Island.
Yeah.
We used to make ramps with them and jump on them and just go all through the woods. And
we saw a guy out here this morning that was jumping this. So back there in that big field.
Really?
Get a, you know, big start and then hop right over it, turn around, do the same thing. There are two more teams back there.
Okay, cool.
Yeah. Hey, guys.
There's more coming?
Yeah, two more.
This is pretty neat, though. I've never done dog sled.
Yeah, it's pretty fun. You guys picked a really good weekend. This is probably the last good weekend of snow. It's supposed to get real warm this week, and we're going to lose a lot of this.
Yeah, I saw something like 60 degrees on Wednesday.
Yeah, it's going to suck. Yeah, we'll probably lose a lot of this and end up going back to the carts. And the carts are kind of fun, but it's kind of like driving an automatic versus a standard car.
Yeah.
This is like the standard. It's got to be really gazed, a lot more fun, kind of do weird stuff. Whereas the carts...
It must keep you in shape, though.
Yeah, sometimes. Dealing with the dogs, picking up, you know, 50, 70-pound dogs all day. No, not keep you in shape.
Well, plus keeping your car in shape because you got to keep with the sled.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd probably be tired after 10 minutes.
Yeah, you get used to it. When I first started, it's a different set of muscles than I'd ever used. Those carts are fun, but you know, they're just easy. It's just handlebars and wheels. They got disc brakes on them, so.
It's a car.
Yeah, exactly. Car pulls like my dogs. So we'll probably have to finish out the winter season with those, but you guys got the last... Today's a great day for snow. We had some snow last night.
Yeah, we were at the ice castles when it started snowing.
Nice. I bet that was cool.
Yeah, it was. Here for the up, up.
There's poop.
You guys probably saw on the way out one of Wes's dogs is really giving him some trouble.
Yeah.
Sometimes the dogs will just be dogs and you can't really control what they do. You good, Praline? Ready? Hey!
fine, don't get along. The next day, one dog will give another dog a weird look and they'll go right at it.
Grumpy day.
Yeah, exactly. The days where it's real cold, where it's below zero, the dogs get the cranky those days.
Taking the kids to like Santa's Village,
yeah, yeah.
Storyland,
yeah.
Fox.
You guys do anything else this weekend?
Yesterday we did ziplining and snow tubing at Loon.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
And then last night we did ice castles. Today we're doing this. Tomorrow we're going to Grand Moor, go tubing
nice.
And ride all the mountain culture and stuff. It was pretty good. The only time I ever ziplined was in December on a cruise ship.
Alright.
I was like, I had never known if I would have liked it. I tried it. I'm like, oh, this is fun.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. I love zipline. I've never been to that place, though.
Now when I see him, I'm going to stop and go do him.
Yeah, good call. It's so fun.
I know. I think they said St. Martin just opened up the longest one in the world.
Yeah?
I forgot how long, but they say it's the longest one.
That'd be pretty sweet. Kind of feel like flying.
Yeah, because even yesterday, the way that they do it over there, you zip line that way, climb the tower, and then zip line back.
Oh, really?
So the first one, I like was like chicken a little bit, stepped on a little bit before stepping on. It's always the step one.
Yeah, that's the hardest part.
Then on the way back, I was like, bye-bye, see you later. That's like at the Stratosphere Hotel in Vegas.
Yeah.
You can jump off 800 feet off the building.
Is that the same one that's got the roller coaster that goes all the way off and then like stops and comes back?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's wild. I think that'd freak me out.
Yeah, I've done all the rides up there.
Yeah.
I just never jumped off. They're kind of freaky. They got like a swing ride.
Yeah.
That the arm extends off the side of the building. And then the seats are pitched. Like, you have no choice but to look down. And you're like, oh my god.
That kind of makes me feel like I'm thinking about it.
And they got the drop tower on the top. You can actually, that's at the end of the strip. You can actually see the first hotel clear as day.
Wow. That's so cool. I think I would do it, but I'd be terrified.
Yeah, because it's like windy up there.
Yeah.
So sometimes the rides don't operate because of the wind.
Sure.
But it's still kind of freaky because you're up there, especially the little roller coaster thing.
Yeah.
And it hangs off the building. It's like 800-900 feet, 1,000 feet off the... I'm like, ah!
That's pretty cool. This is stuff that makes you feel alive.
Oh, I know. It freaks you out, though, because you hear the... You know, when it stops, it makes that bang. They gotta
yeah.
go, and it just freaks you out. You're like, oh my god, I'm going to go all over. But then you get off, you're like, yeah, that was nothing.
Yeah. Again. Come on. Good dogs. Alright, Fraylene. Oh.
What I really find interesting is they know where to go.
Yeah, yeah. Especially this last part. I got everyone's going home.
What's up, Lightning? Hey, girl. Good dogs. Keep on going. All right. What's up, Scrappy?